Hey beautiful Virgo, hope you're doing well. If you're new to the channel, my name is Leela. I reside in London, UK, and I'm also a Virgo. Shouts out to my returning subs. You know who you are, baby. I'm going to do a general love reading. It may or may not resonate with you. If you find something does resonate with you, please go ahead and smash the thumbs button, okay? Show some love to the channel. Lovely to see the Wheel of Fortune on the bottom of the deck. This can indicate big changes, luck being en route also, all right? So, who's thinking about Virgo? We have the Ace of Swords. Let's put it here. Who's thinking about Virgo? Five of Wands. Who's thinking about Virgo? Who's got Virgo on their mind? Two of Swords. It came out reverse. So it's like I almost want to say, for some of you guys, you may have unblocked this person. It's not going to be for everybody, okay? So the Ace of Swords. Let's talk about the Ace of Swords. It's somebody that's very blunt, very truthful, I think. This is all about clarity. Somebody that likes to speak their mind. Okay, I want to say a wandering eye. That's what just came to my head. Somebody with a wandering eye. I could be wrong, Virgo. The Five of Wands indicates that there could have been or has been some sort of disagreements, arguments, something along those lines. It's a very competitive energy. Okay, you can also talk about drama. Whoever is just thinking about you, Two of Swords, they could be in denial about something here. Maybe in denial of how they feel about you, in denial with their selves. This is about not wanting to face the truth, blinding themselves from the truth, okay? So yeah, whoever is just thinking about you, I reckon there's some issues here. Maybe you want some clarity, you want to know where you stand. Maybe this person is quite withdrawn. They distance themselves. They don't want to face you because maybe it's going to lead to an argument or something like that. I reckon some of you guys have got some stuff you want to get off your chest. But I feel like this person's avoiding you, avoiding the truth and perhaps what needs to be said. Okay, that's what I'm getting anyway. Let's move on to who wants Virgo? The Empress card. Who wants Virgo? Who wants Virgo? I saw that was. Hang on a sec, guys. Seven of Pentacles. It's kind of giving me the ick. And I say that because I feel like there's no movement here. Who wants Virgo? Who wants Virgo? Yeah, no movement. It's like quite stuck energy. I reckon this person's been thinking about you a lot. As you can see, this person is also blindfolded, not wanting to face the truth, not wanting to let go, whether that's let go of you or let go of past situations or behaviors or a way of thinking, all right? There is a lot of thinking here. This person feels stuck on you. There's an unconditional love of the Empress card here. For some of you guys, it may be a Taurus, it may be a Libra. It doesn't have to be that sign. There is unconditional love here, though. There is grace. The person that wants you, they see your grace. They see how nurturing and loving and caring you are. Yeah. They've been thinking about you. Maybe they're waiting. They're hoping that you're going to reach out. And I feel like it's them, you know, they're expecting or wanting you to put in the work. And I know a lot of Virgos, you're not going to do that. Why? Why are you not going to do that? Because you've put a lot of work in already. Like this person's waiting for you, or maybe waiting for better to come along. Like, yes, I said it, they're not going to be for everybody, but there's no point sugarcoating shit around here, okay? Whoever it is that wants you, they're behaving in a way that doesn't serve them. It's not for their highest good, okay? They're stuck, they feel stagnant, stuck on you, stuck in some sort of time warp. Maybe you want change, Virgo, and they're not giving you change. Maybe you're the one that's sitting around waiting, hoping, expecting them to love on you. Yeah. Who truly loves Virgo? Queen of Cups, Five of Cups. Who truly loves Virgo? Page of Cups. A lot of water energy here. Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio for some of you guys, okay? The Queen of Cups suggests compassion, understanding, unconditional love, intuitive energy. Whoever is that truly loves you, they're sad about something here, or they regret something here, they're disappointed. This is someone that's concentrating on what could go wrong rather than what could go right. Then we have the Page of Cups here, which indicates maybe someone that's younger than you. And they don't have to be younger than you. It could be somebody that is chasing their youth. There's definitely feelings. There's definitely love towards you. The Page of Cups can indicate an apology, an offer of some kind. Maybe you're the one that's been offering this person. You've been implementing unconditional love. However, there is this Five of Cups energy. Let's try and clarify this Five of Cups. Why is the Five of Cups here with regards to the person that truly loves Virgo? Why is the Five of Cups here? Three of Pentacles. Why is the Five of Cups here? A conversation needs to be had. Five of Cups again. A conversation needs to be had, or there's going to be a conversation which can lead to some sort of sadness, disappointment, regret. I knew you were going to do this. I knew that this was going to happen. The Ace of Pentacles talks about new beginnings. Maybe there's too much water under the bridge. There is potential here with cooperation, with listening, understanding, communication, awkward conversations that sometimes, you know, we don't want to have, but needs to be had here in order for this new beginning to come in. And then maybe you'll get your clarity. Remember, I could be talking about one person in particular or multiple people, okay? I want to see what's coming towards you, Virgos, in love. And then we're going to see what the hidden truth is. How's your weekend been, Virgo? If you're new to the channel, let me know in the comment section where you reside. I'm in London, UK, if I haven't said that already. What's coming towards Virgos in love? What's the energy of love coming towards Virgos? What's coming towards Virgos in love? The Queen of Pentacles talks about your energy. The King of Swords. The Queen of Wands. I feel like I like the Strength card here on the bottom of the deck. It indicates your healing energy, how calming you are as a person, you know, very loving, very compassionate. But also there's a side to this, you know, don't mess with Virgo. Virgo's got another side to them, okay? Don't test it. Don't test the Virgo. You've been patient. A lot of you guys have been extremely patient with regards to love. Sorry, there's something under my nail. Can't get rid of it. I see someone here in your energy. They're very intelligent. They could be coming towards you. They're in your energy already. They're very intelligent, clever. A Mr. or Mrs. Know-it-all, always has the last answer. They're full of wisdom. I would give them that. They can be very cold and calculating, or at least it feels like that. This can be someone that can be manipulative. I feel like, and it's not going to be for everybody, that, but there could be another woman, another person. There could be third party situations going on here. Some of you guys know exactly who it is I'm talking about. Others of you may be scratching your head. Okay, I feel like a lot of you guys, a lot of Virgos, especially female Virgos, are going to be working on their confidence, building their confidence, starting to feel comfortable in their own skin, starting to feel like yourselves again. Yeah, this person likes that. They're going to notice that. It's always someone that will try and come and fuck up your head, Virgo, or come and try and spin your head, make you start to question yourself. But you've got to remember all the work that you've done, all the progress that you've made, okay? there's been a lot of progress. So continue to work on yourself, okay? What is meant for you is always going to be for you. Let me pull out some hidden truth cards. And then we're going to wrap it up. Remember, you can book me for a personal, just get in touch. You can follow me on the socials, you can catch me for live tarot. If you'd like to donate to the channel today, there is a PayPal link in the about section. You're not obliged to do so, but I appreciate all support that is given. I want to feel that way again. This could be you, Virgo, you know, a particular person. I'm so attracted to you. But there's got to be more than attraction, like physical attraction. You know, you've got to tick all the boxes. It's time for me to heal now. And I feel like a lot of you guys are doing that already. I want to tell you how I feel. Well, do it already, because there's a lot of Virgos that's been waiting for somebody to be emotionally expressive, open, mature. You've been doing a lot of healing. There is somebody here in your energy that's attracted to you. And with the I want to feel that way again, ain't no one going to come close to you, baby. You know, as in, no one's going to tick all the boxes like you tick all the boxes, Virgo. Anyway, very general love reading. I'm going to leave it there. Please remember to smash the thumbs button, support the channel. I do free daily readings. So all you got to do really, as a bare minimal, is to smash the thumbs button. Even if you didn't like it, smash the thumbs down. I don't give a toss, okay? Just interact with it. And if you haven't subscribed already, please do so. Much love to you. As I always say, from one Virgo to another, be kind to others, but most importantly, be kind to you. And the gift will catch you on the rebound, baby. Mwah.